So we start Blackbird in G with our middle finger on the third fret of the bottom E string, and we want to hit the B string open. And the picking pattern is hitting the bottom E and the B string. And that G string is droning throughout the song, you'll notice. So you're always coming up and with your index finger to the right hand, just hitting that open G. So. So we want to go third fret, bottom E. So hit that B and the G after. And then you want to hit an open A string with your thumb. And then with your finger on the right hand, hit that first fret of the B string. So. Then move to the second fret of the A string. And then the third fret of the B string. All the time just hitting that G straight after you play those two notes. So. And then slide up to the 10th fret of the A string and hit the 12th fret of the B string. And this is where the picking pattern changes a little, so. So I used to play this totally wrong, and the way Paul seems to play it is he plucks those two, the A and the B strings, with his thumb and maybe his middle finger, his right hand. And then I always used to play it like picking it all, so. But it looks like he actually plays it by plucking the A and the B strings and then just using the nail of his index finger and the right hand to just flick the G and the B strings, so. So you're flicking it, and then you're coming up and hitting that open G again, so. It's quite tough to get, I still can't get it completely right, but if you play along with a record, you can sort of hear it and emulate what he's doing, so. So once you've finished that part on the 10th fret, you go down to the C, so you're on the 3rd fret of the A string, and we go back to the original picking pattern, so now 3rd fret A string, and 5th fret of the B string, hitting that G again on the up. And then you want the bass note to go up one, so the A string goes from 3rd to the 4th fret, and you put your index finger now on the top E on the 3rd fret, so. And then you want to go up another fret on the bass string and put your index finger on the 5th fret of the A, with your finger on the B string of the 7th fret. One more on the bass string, so A goes to the 6th fret and your index finger goes to the 5th fret of the top E. All the while hitting that droning G string at the end of each pluck. So. And then you go back to that other picking pattern, so you go to the 7th fret of the A string and the 8th fret of the B string. Using that right hand index finger to sort of flick that G and the B strings. Down one fret, just on the A string this time, so down from the 7th to the 6th, keep your finger on the 8th fret of the B string line. Then we move that whole shape down a fret. So 5th fret of the A, 7th fret of the B. And that's just one pluck of those two strings, so don't hit the G, just the A and the B string. And then quickly go to the 4th fret of the A string, and on the top E, the 3rd fret. think so. Back to that C, so the third fret of the A string and the fifth fret of the B string. And then go back to the other picking pattern again, which is the flicking one. Down one fret just on the B string, so you make a minor chord. And then move that whole shape down one, so second fret of the A, third fret of B. Now you go to an open A and B string second fret. Then to a D, open D string, and then on the B string first fret. So. And then finish by hitting that G. So third fret on the bottom E, and then just pick the G and the B strings open. So for the first little musical interlude part, you're doing that G again with the open B string. So it's just like a first little taste of the verse that you're doing. So it's the same, the open A and the B string first fret, second fret on the A, third fret on the B, to that C, so third fret A, fifth fret B string, so from that you go to the second fret A, third fret B, and then to the open A, second fret B, and then the D open with the B string first fret. Back to that G. So for the chorus, you start up on the 8th fret of the A string, and you want to, on the B string, be on the 10th fret. And you're still doing that same pattern, so strumming those two strings, hitting the open G with your index finger on the right hand. So, that first one. Down one fret to the 7th fret on the A string, and down two frets to the 8th fret on the B string. And then bring that whole position down two frets, so 5th fret on the A string and 6th fret on the B string. And then do that C, so you're on the 3rd fret of the A string and the 5th fret of the B string. So. And then you go down to a B flat on the A string, so 1st fret A string and the 3rd fret on the B string. And then use that picking technique with the strumming on the right hand index finger. And then move that whole shape up two frets, so third fret A string, fifth fret B string. Back up to the 8th fret and 10th fret on the B. Back down to that B flat. And then we do an open A string and 2nd fret on the B string. Open D string and then 1st fret on the B string. And then back to the G. So. So there's a part in the middle of the song where on the White Album version you hear the Blackbird start tweeting and everything. So there's a couple of different ways to play it, but I'll play it sort of as he does on the album. Live he sort of does something like that, but we'll try and do what he does on the album. So it's sort of the first part of the verse. So we slide up to that 10th fret on the A, 12th fret on the B string, and we just stick on that chord, so. Using that first finger of the right hand to do the picking technique. And he sort of slows down just of his own accord, so just play by feel. And then he just sort of slides down the neck with that chord. And then he goes into the other little interlude sass. But this time it's a little bit different than the last interlude, so. So it's a really quick one on that penultimate note, so. G to the C. So when you go to that A, and open A and the second fret B, you quickly go to that next open the first fret on the B, so. And then strum it with that same technique, so. And then go straight back into the verse. So for the outro, we come off that last verse. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. This moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. So you're basically playing the same verse that we played before, but when you come to the end of the verse, you're doing that C, so. You were only waiting. So 3rd fret on the A, 5th fret on the B, 2nd fret A, 3rd fret B. You were only. And then when you get to waiting, move to the open A, 2nd fret B. You were only waiting for this. When you say moment, go on to the 1st fret of the B string, open D string. You were only waiting for this moment to say arise, go on to the G. So, you were only waiting for this moment to arise. And then incorporate that in with that picking technique, so. Mm-hmm. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise. So on the last time, I think it repeats it 3 times at the end, that little section. On the last time, you leave some space. So it's, you were only waiting for this moment. So those last 2 parts, just let them ring out. You were only waiting for this moment. Actually, the last part, let ring out. So you were only waiting for this moment to arise. And then play a G chord. Right at the end. Okay, thanks a lot for watching the lesson, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a like. Click subscribe by clicking in the bottom right hand corner. Add a comment to say any other lessons that you want to learn. Share it with all your friends. And happy birthday, Paul. Hope you enjoy it.